Hi friends, welcome to today's video. So today we are going to deal with data sufficiency question. So today's question is, if x greater than y, the first statement given is x minus y is equal to 7, and second statement given is 2x plus y is equal to 9. So if only first statement alone is sufficient to answer the question, you have to answer as A. Or if the second statement alone is sufficient to answer the question, you have to answer it as B. If either first statement or second statement is enough to answer the question, you have to give it as C. If both the statements are required to answer the question, you have to answer it as D. And elephant should be given or E should be given if neither 1 nor 2 are sufficient to answer the question. So this is how the data sufficiency questions will be asked. So here the question is x greater than y? So you have to find out whether x is greater than y. So the first statement given is x minus y is equal to 7. So x minus y is equal to 7, from this statement you can very well understand that x is greater than y. So first statement will give you the answer to the question. But you have to check whether the second statement also is giving the answer, because we are having an option. Either statement 1 or statement 2 is sufficient to answer the question. So both the statements, even 1 can also answer the question, 1 alone can also answer the question, 2 alone can also answer the question. So such a choice is there. So you have to check option number 2 also. Statement number 2 also you have to check. You should not end with only statement number 1. So you are going to check statement number 2. So what is statement number 2? 2x plus y is equal to 9. So do you get any idea here, like x is greater or y is greater? You are not getting any idea. You will be getting 2x is equal to 9 minus y. So it can be a decimal number. Y can be a decimal number, or x can be a decimal number, or a fraction. So you do not know. It can be a whole number. It can be a natural number. So you are not getting any idea whether x is greater than y by this statement 2x is equal to 9 minus 5. So second statement will not give you the answer. Only the first statement is giving you the answer, and first statement alone is sufficient to give you the answer. So your option will be option A. Second question, if x greater than y. First statement is x is a multiple of y, and second statement is x by 12 is equal to y by 6. So you have to find out, is x greater than y? So first statement is x is a multiple of y. So x is equal to py. X is a multiple of y, that is given. So x is equal to py, but this p can be any number. So p can be 1. If p is equal to 1 means x is equal to y. So you cannot surely say that x is greater than y. Only statement given is x is a multiple of y. So p can be 1 also. If p is equal to 1, then x is equal to y, x is not greater than y. Or if p is any other number means x will be greater than y. But you cannot be sure. You don't know whether x is a multiple of y means x is greater than y. It does not infer. So x is equal to py equation does not infer that x is greater than y. Even p can be a fraction also. Suppose p can be 1 by 2 or p can be 1 by 4. If that is the case, means x will be less than y. So we are not sure about the value of p when we say x is equal to py. So statement 1 alone is not giving you the answer. And what about statement 2? So let us solve. It is given x by 12 is equal to y by 6. So from that you will be getting your x is equal to 2y. So x is equal to 2y means that x is greater than y. Always that will be the case. X is equal to 2y implies that x is greater than y. So statement 2 alone is sufficient to answer the question, but statement 1 alone is not sufficient to answer the question. So your answer will be B. Now third question, again, is x greater than y? And the first statement given is x square minus 4x plus 4 is equal to 0. And second statement is y square minus 6y plus 12 is equal to 2y minus 4. So there are two statements given. You have to find out, is x greater than y? So first statement is x square minus 4x plus 4 is equal to 0. So by solving this equation, you will be finding out the value of x. So this is actually x minus 2 the whole square is equal to 0, which implies x is equal to 2. Then what about second statement? Y square minus 6y plus 12 is equal to 2y minus 4, which will be giving you y square minus 8y plus 16 is equal to 0, which will be giving you y minus 4 the whole square is equal to 0. So y is equal to 4. So from the first statement, you got x is equal to 2. And from second statement, you will be getting y is equal to 4. So x is equal to 2 is not giving you any indication of whether x is greater than y. And y is equal to 4 is not giving any indication whether x is greater than y. But the two statements together, first statement gives you x is equal to 2 and second statement gives you y is equal to 4. So the two statements together will be indicating that x is greater than y. So your option will be option C. Both the statements 1 and 2 are sufficient to answer the question. Both 1 and 2 together, you will be able to answer the question. So here x is equal to 2, y is equal to 4. So you will be getting the answer x is not greater than y. So C is the answer. Next question, if P and Q are integers, is P plus Q an odd number? Your first statement is 8 less than P less than 11. And second statement is 7 less than Q less than 10. You have to find out whether P plus Q is an odd number or not. So you know that the sum of two odd numbers will always be equal to even. So you can say that 3 plus 3. Suppose you are taking two odd numbers. 3 plus 3 is equal to 6. Or 5 plus 3 is equal to 8. Sum of two odd numbers will be always giving you an even number. Then what about the sum of two even numbers? Two even numbers will be always giving you even only. So when will you be getting an odd number? When you are adding an odd number and an even number, you will be getting an odd number. 3 plus 2 is equal to 5 or 4 plus 1 is equal to 5. So when you are adding an even number and an odd number, you will be getting an odd number. So that is what you have to look for, whether we are always adding an even number and an odd number. When you are adding two odd numbers together, you will be getting an even number. Or when you are adding two even numbers together also, you will be getting an even number only. So you have to add an odd number and an even number to get an odd number as the answer. So here from the first statement, what you will be getting? P can have two values. What are they? 9 and 10. It is given like 8 less than P less than 11. So from the first statement, you will be getting P can have two values, 9 and 10. And what about second statement? Q can have two values. What are they? 8 and 9. The two values possible for Q is equal to 8 and 9. So suppose P is having the value 9 and Q is having the value 8. Then you will be getting 9 plus 8 is equal to 17. It is an odd number. But suppose P is equal to 9 and Q is equal to 9. Then you will be getting 9 plus 9 is equal to 18. So that time P plus Q is not an odd number. P plus Q is an even number. So you cannot be sure whether which value P takes or which value Q takes. P can take any of the values 9 and 10. At the same time, Q can take any of the values 8 and 9. So you won't be able to say whether P plus Q is an odd number or not. Even if you are considering both the statements together, you will not be able to tell whether P plus Q is an odd number. So both the statements are not sufficient to answer the question, or neither one nor two are sufficient to answer the question. So your option will be option E or elephant. Thank you for watching.